done in 1985. My oldest sister was murdered by her husband. He drowned my sister in the tub, and at the time, she had 3 kids. She had a son that was 10, a son that was 3, and a daughter that was 5. So, like I said, that was in 85. This year marked the 25th year anniversary of our sister's death. So for us to see where violence is at, from then to now, it's really, really, really worse to us. And we hope that we can change the way people think. So everybody here, that if they change the gun laws, they can change. Y'all hear that? Y'all hear that? If the mayor talks about any more cops on the street, he thinks that's going to be a solution. How many people think that those are solutions to the issues we're having today? Meaning, if we change the way people think, because like I said, he strangled my sister. He didn't shoot her, he didn't stab her, there was no cops around, it wasn't because there wasn't enough police around. If we could just change the way people think, then maybe that would be the first step to solving a lot of issues that we have that we're dealing with today.
So I sink the ink on this pen and this page and hope that just one day they'll realize that my message and presence on my assignment as a mind and as rich in my mind and as bright was time. So I write this line, this is my last time. My last shift, my last voice, my last dance, my last step, my last word, my last friend, my last pen. And now this must come to an end because my only friend, this pen, had just lost his ink just like the rest of my friends had lost their soul in violence. And now that I'm in silence, I look to the sky and I send my last goodbyes to all my friends and hope that just one day we'll all meet again.
Don't feel like that you are queen. Raised from these streets, God didn't raise no princesses. Boys, stop wearing your pants hanging. All you're doing is hanging up your white flag, going into what they want you to be. A human being is what you are. Never let anyone reduce you to a nigga, a boy in the block, a lowlife, or a hood rat. And never accept the title of a prince. You are king, you are royalty. And remember, when you look in the mirror, you should see more than the money in the cars, cars, and clothes, the gold. Because all you get is hopes in your future, don't cheat yourself. And remember, that success is past materialized things. So let's expand our horizons and rise to kings and queens.
Yes!
For every action is a reaction. These are the basic laws of life. And one broken law can cause a life. And a careless cause can offer life. It's awful, right? The scene of a lifeless body is an awful sight. Like the story of one girl, two friends, one bad choice, and four lives in. One girl, two friends, one bad choice, and four lives in. Play.
Hey, yo, Matt. I just met this bad chick.
Yeah. Describe, what's her name?
Man, her name Daisy. Five thick in the thighs, ice cream free. Everything you got, handsome world. Man, you crazy. I'm just trying to hit that. You already know where my head at.
Let's talk right back. Let's talk a lot.
Alright.
Yo, Dave. What's up, Dave?
Nothing.
What you done?
Nothing. Finna call Tiz right back.
You finna call Tiz right back? Hell know what to do with that. When he needs a trip, I'm gonna come right through back.
Look, babe, I know how much you want me to be your lady, but Tiz told me to know I'm finna have this baby.
What? You finna have this baby? Tiz don't even want you. I'm gonna throw you a couple of miles, but that baby will not.
What? That's my girl.
Listen, baby, I'm just keeping it real with you. Tiz be out hungry. You ain't gonna want me to bring me back something.
Bring me back something? I don't want no disease. What I look like with AIDS, like, man, please.
Listen, we'll talk about this face to face. I bet you dream about the cold AIDS.
Pause. Now, as he walks into the house of his so-called friend, waiting to conceal this hideous sin, he loosens his buckle and begins to chuckle and says,
"What if Tiz walk in right now?"
And before the words can come out this lip, Tiz walks in with a gun on his hip, pausing, eyes beaming. Pause. Life is like a card game. Difference I was playing. You lied to, cheated and betrayed. Folks can pretend like friends and behave. Loyal and kind, but you'll be amazed. Lie, scream, cry, you will. But pain never is a reason to kill. Pain never is a reason to kill. Unmute, play.
Listen, you don't gotta do this.
That's where you shoot this.
But I made the game.
betrayed, folks can pretend and behave, loyal and kind, but you'll be amazed. Laugh, scream, cry, you will. Never is a reason to kill.
My name is Herman Davis. I'm here at Ben Franklin High School. I'm with Peace and Love. We did today our program, Langham and the program, The Art of Peace and Love, talking to the kids about choices, decisions that they make, and trying to let them realize that they are our future and how much power that they have. Today was an amazing program. We had the poets do pieces touching on sexual abuse, touching on domestic violence, touching on the vacant of a parent, invisible parents. You know, we did some Q&A, we got some feedback from the kids on their teachers and what they need from their teachers, and just, good communication. With Peace and Love, we just try to talk to the kids and focus on making the right decisions. I shared the story with the kids today on how Peace and Love got started. And it got started because my older sister was murdered by her husband. Our mayor here in Philadelphia, he talks about, putting more cops on the street. You see in the news, changing gun laws. Well, my sister wasn't shot. It has nothing to do with gun laws. My sister was drowned in the tub. It had nothing to do because it wasn't enough police officers. It was in the house. He drowned her in the house in the tub. And he had the choice to stop choking her or to keep choking her. And if we can just help society think about the choices that they make. The other thing that we touched on today was forgiving. Going through the therapeutic part of it, learning how to control your emotions and understanding what those emotions are. For me, it took me 20 years to realize I had to forgive the man that killed my sister. Forgiving is a big part of healing. And with Peace and Love, these are the things that we touch on. We just want people to know, want the world to know, because Peace and Love isn't a Philadelphia movement. This is a national movement, targeted to be an international movement. We know that there are some powers that are greater than us, but we also realize this is not heaven. This is not heaven on earth. This is not the reality of what we live in. But if we could just outweigh good with bad, like, that's it, right? And with Peace and Love, we just want everybody to know, it starts with you. It starts with me, it starts with you. You have the choice when that person cuts you off on a highway to either, race up a little closer, get next to him and give him the middle finger, or just let him go ahead. It's cool, you cut me off, you got that. No big deal. Oh, you stepped in my shoe? No big deal, I know you really didn't mean it. Oh, you bumped me? No big deal, don't worry about it. Oh no, baby, let me hold the door for you, let me let you in. Let me give you the respect that you deserve. These are just the things that we're trying to do with Peace and Love. That's it, real easy, real cookie cutter, that's it. Peace and Love.